Hi, this is Greg. Look for my book, The Agile Brand, on Amazon or on my website at theagile.world. Welcome back to The Agile World. This is Greg Kilstrom. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about design thinking. There's a lot of people that are working in a few different worlds. I would say design thinking and agile thinking often have some overlap, and I think that's a good thing. I think they actually can complement one another. I think sometimes one may get confused with another in certain circles, but I wanted to talk a little bit about it. I discussed it in a lot more detail in my book, The Agile Brand. But design thinking does share a lot of positive things with agile thinking. For those of you less familiar, I think design thinking actually first came into being, I think, as a term probably in the late 50s, early 60s, and really came into prevalence by David M. Kelly, who founded IDEO. And I think that was in the early 90s when he founded that firm. They've really, kind of embraced it and exemplified it and really kind of made it part of their brand. Design thinking is a pretty interesting approach to really anything. It's not, while it uses the term design in it, it's not simply about design-related fields. So it's not only about architecture or graphic design or web design or things like that. It's really about an approach where we are building a product, a service, a way of thinking, even an organization in some cases, around a customer. And so, you know, while at first this seems kind of interesting, it still sounds kind of interesting to me, but it sounds kind of daunting, I guess, to, you know, what if we threw away all of the conventions? What if we built a bank around a customer instead of assuming that the way that a bank was made in the late 1800s is the way that it always should be? I think we see some interesting things where, there's been a few. I believe Umpqua Bank in the Northwest really led the charge in some really, really innovative thinking here. But more recently, Capital One has adopted this idea of bank cafes. So I'm based here in D.C., and there's a few popping up here in various neighborhoods here. And, you know, kind of an interesting concept where technically it's a bank branch, but it's also you can sit and hang out and get coffee. And I don't know how the quality of their coffee stacks up against others, but, kind of an interesting concept where, okay, let's build an experience around something that we believe our customers need instead of, again, trying to force someone into an old way of thinking. I think it's, this applies, again, in that physical world and building a space around a customer. That's one example, but also just thinking about other, whether it's a software process or an organizational process. What if we didn't have to do things the way that we always did them? And let's rethink, if we were to design it from scratch, what would we do? And so design thinking actually has very similar stages and processes to agile, or even, some waterfall thinking, delivering or defining the problem. So, requirements gathering, as many of us are familiar with. The next stage would be what they refer to as need finding and benchmarking. So, after we kind of gather the requirements, let's learn a little bit about what are the problems. Again, we know we want to sell checking accounts to people, but what does our audience actually want from us? The next step would be ideating. So, okay, now that we've kind of matched our goals with our customers' goals, what can we do? What are the initial ideas that come out of that? Then we go into building and then ultimately testing. This really maps to an agile process very well, because once you get through that requirements gathering and building, get into the building stage, then you can really follow the sprint-based model of, okay, let's try something, let's test it, and let's iterate, optimize, all of those kinds of things. And really, that's where I think design thinking and agile really play well together. In the next episode, I'm going to talk about future generations and how agile brands can reach out to them and embrace them. Thanks for listening. See you next week. If you enjoyed this episode and found it helpful, please rate the show on iTunes or contact me through my website at theagile.world. You can find my books, The Agile Brand and The Agile Web, on Amazon and on my website at theagile.world.